of Kensington Street in the amount of $15,745.86. Funds provided from local streets.
Motion.
Support. We have a motion by Councilwoman Cross, supported by Councilman Ramick for approval. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All those opposed say no. Motion carries. Item 24 is a motion to approve a resolution authorizing execution of Wayne County 2019 annual permits, which states the City of Taylor agrees to fulfill all permit obligations, hold harmless, and defend Wayne County, and authorizes Keith Boc, Executive Director, DPS, and Greg Mayhew, City Engineer, to sign the annual maintenance permit A19070, the annual pavement restoration permit A19125, and the annual special event permit A19155.
Motion.
Support. We have a motion by Councilwoman Pat, supported by Councilman Woolley for approval. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All those opposed say no. Motion carries. Next on our agenda is item 25. It's a motion to approve environmental resources to perform asbestos testing and environmental site assessments in the amount of $4,950.
Support.
We have a motion by Councilwoman Cross, supported by Councilman Woolley for approval. Is there any discussion?
This is just
Councilwoman Nass.
Just want to let everyone know, this is the old farmhouse that is at Heritage Park next to the Penning Farm. It's a little white house right there. That's what this is here.
Is there any further discussion? Hearing none, we have a motion by Councilman Cross, supported by Councilman Woolley for approval. All those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All those opposed say no. Motion carries. Item 26 is a motion to approve the Michigan Department of Transportation performance resolution for governmental agencies, which is required of the City of Taylor to apply for an annual application and permit for miscellaneous operations within the state highway right-of-way.
Motion.
Support.
We have a motion by Councilman Ramick, supported by Councilman Mazura for approval. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All those opposed say no. Motion carries. Next item on our agenda is item 27. It's a motion to approve the January 2019 payroll.
Motion to approve.
Support.
We have a motion by Councilwoman Cross, supported by Councilman Ramick for approval. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All those opposed say no. Motion carries. Item 28 is a motion to approve the tentative collective bargaining agreement between the City of Taylor and the Taylor Police Officers Labor Association, as represented by the Police Officers Association of Michigan.
Motion.
Support.
We have a motion by Councilman Ramick, supported by Councilwoman Croft for approval. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All those opposed say no. Motion carries. Next on our agenda is item 29. It's a motion to approve opening nominations to fill the vacant chairperson position on the Taylor City Council.
Motion.
We have a motion by Councilwoman Croft, supported by Councilman Johnson. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, all the papers say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no. Motion carries. Nominations are now open for filling the vacant chairperson position. Councilman Johnson.
I would like to make a motion to nominate Tim Woolley, effective first meeting in January.
Of course.
Okay. We have a motion by Councilman Johnson, supported by Councilwoman Croft, for Tim Woolley to be accepted as the chairperson. Are there any other nominations? Okay. Need a motion to close, or actually, you know what, approve the nomination. So we have a motion by Councilman Johnson, supported by Councilwoman Croft, to approve the nomination of Councilman Woolley for the position. Is there any discussion? Councilman Woolley, do you accept the nomination?
Mr. Chairman, I do.
Okay. Any other discussion? Okay. All those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All those opposed say no. Motion carries. Councilman Woolley being nominated, he's voted in by acclamation. So we'll entertain a motion to close nominations.
Motion to close nominations.
Support.
We have a motion by Councilwoman Croft, supported by Councilman Mazura, to close the nominations. Is there any discussion?
Mr. Chairman.
Yes.
I'm a little late from the last one, but I just want to thank the nomination of Mr. Johnson. And,
Yes.
All opposed, seeing none, motion carries. Congratulations, Councilman Lloyd.
Thank you.
Next item on our agenda is item 32, which is open business, and as customary, we will go to council for open business items. I actually have one item to bring forward, I can find the language. It's a motion to approve the Knights of Columbus Taylor to be recognized as a nonprofit organization operating in the community for purpose of obtaining a charitable gaming license.
Motion.
Support. We have a motion by Councilman Ratliff, supported by Councilman Mazzura, to approve this charitable gaming license application. All those in favor, or I'm sorry, is there any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor say yes.
Yes.
All opposed say no. Motion carries. Is there any other open business items, Mr. Chairman? Councilman Mazzura.
I've got a motion that I'd like to bring forward. It reads, motion to stop payroll to the city treasurer effective January 1st, 2019. Direct human resources to send a letter to the city treasurer advising him of this council action. City council will further examine the treasurer position to determine if a vacancy should be declared per section 4.3 of our city charter.
Is there a support for the motion?
Support.
We have a motion by Councilman Mazzura, supported by Councilman Woolley. Which reads, a motion to stop payroll to the city treasurer effective January 1st, 2019, and to direct the human resources to send a letter to the city treasurer advising him of the council action. City council will further examine the treasurer's position to determine if a vacancy should be declared per section 4.3 of our city charter. We have a motion by Councilman Mazzura, supported by Councilman Woolley for approval. Is there any discussion?
Mr. Chairman?
Councilman Mazzura.
No, I just wanted to ask for council,
sure,
what this means, how is it legal, is it legal?
Yes, the city has, the council has the right to pass a resolution directing the city to do what is directed here. The city then has the right to confer with its HR people to determine that they're not violating any employment laws. We've looked at that, and that there is no violation under FMLA or under the Americans with Disability Act that would prevent us from stop payment to the treasurer, as he's been on paid leave for some time, and based on the fact that he's been on leave for so long, any continued length of leave would not be a reasonable accommodation, and it's appropriate that his salary be stopped at this time.
Okay. Is there any other further discussion on this item? Councilman Ram.
Just a question. Let's say he decides to come back to work tomorrow, or next week, or after Christmas, to start back up.
Well, the issue that we have is the vacancy of office. And the vacancy of offices can be declared by the city council if an elected official has not been at work or has not performed the duties of his work for 90 days.
I just want to be sure of one thing, because from some of the things from the past, we know, I'm pretty sure most of us know, that he has supposedly been working from home. Does that make any difference?
We have examined that, and we are still under, still looking at how much and if at all he has been working.
Mr. Chairman,
Councilman Mazzura.
My background on it, in terms of why I brought this forward, I look at, you know, the fact that he hasn't physically come to work in 10 months. So, you know, I've heard the potential for there to be this concept of work at home, and this isn't a disability. It's just I'm performing my work functions from a remote location. I look at it and see that he hasn't been to work in 10 months. He's a member of our city's two pension boards. There's monthly meetings that he's required to attend. He hasn't attended those meetings in 11 months. Right now, if any one of us pick up our phone and call the call center and try and get through to the treasurer, we're
were immediately transferred to the deputy treasurer. So if I'm a resident and I'm trying to sit here tonight, listen to this discussion and determine if my treasurer's working for home, when he hasn't been to work in 10 months, he hasn't been to a planning board meeting in 11 months, you can't physically get a hold of him if you call his office. I don't know if he's logging into his computer, but I don't know if there's any transactions that he can conduct if he does. You know, a lot of the banking that we do on behalf of the city, which would fall under his realm, wire transfers, account transfers, they require dual control and multiple authorities. All that is being done by the deputy treasurer and by somebody in budget and finance. So if we have a treasurer who's not even looking at our bank accounts and is not able to conduct a banking transaction, I don't know how many times he's logged into his computer, but I don't know that he's meeting the charter requirement of doing his job. You bring up a good point. What if he came back? We initially were told it was May. We were then told it was August. We were then told it was November. Then we were told it is May. I don't know if he'll come back. I can't speak to that. What I can do is read the charter and say, are the residents of the city of Taylor being properly represented by the guy they voted into office? And if not, then I think us as elected officials should take action on that. My motion says stop paying and then have a further discussion. Everybody up here already agrees that what's occurred the past 10 months is a vacancy in office. We can make another motion to declare that vacancy tonight. I at least wanted to address the payroll issue. I guess my summary would be, we can't, as elected officials, continue to allow a fellow elected official to continue to get paid. There's no benefits, there's no short-term leave, there's no long-term leave. You can't get a better deal because you're an elected official than if you were an employee of the city of Taylor. It needs to stop. We need to eliminate the pay, and we need to pursue whether or not we should be filling this position with someone else per the requirements of the city charter.
Councilman